liquor got me second guessing. Yeah, yeah. Now we 5 shots deep. Now we 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 shots deep. I'ma need a second.
Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. As you can tell by the title of this video, it's final season. Which is actually pretty crazy because it felt like just not that long ago I was making my It's Midterm Season video, which you can watch right here, and now we are well underway with finals. I've already finished 3 out of the 4 finals that I have for this term, and I just have one more tomorrow, which is my CS final. So today I'm going to start studying for that final, but before that I still have to go through the last module. And then after I go through that module, I will
definitely start studying.
We're starting off the day nice and early at 4 p.m. So yeah, let's get to work. I'ma need a second. Woo! All this liquor got me second guessing. Yeah, yeah. Now we 5 shots deep. Now we 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 shots deep. So this module was about computing history, and some of the topics it touched upon include the origins of functional programming from lambda calculus, Alan Turing's work with the Turing machine, and some early programming languages like Fortran, COBOL, and Lisp. So it's like 5:45 right now, and I'm not even done the module. In fact, I'm like halfway done because at 4:30 I went to take a 5-minute break, and here we are over an hour later, still on that break, which is great. Pull up to the gate, you already buzzing, I can see it in your face. Mixing coke with that Hennessy, keeping you company. So right now it's like 10 and I haven't even started studying yet, but I finally finished that module a couple hours ago, and right now I thought I'd talk a bit about the course, which is called CS135. And unlike most introductory CS courses, CS135 is taught in an amazing language called Racket, which is a functional programming language that is very different from imperative languages like Python, Java, C, C++. And one of the biggest differences is that there are no loops in Racket, and so everything has to be done recursively. A lot of people hate on Racket because it's really annoying, especially if you have background with like an imperative language. You'll find it to be quite annoying when you first start out with it, but I think it wasn't that bad working with it for this course. It was quite interesting to learn functional programming, and overall I really did enjoy the course. I think it was really well organized, the assignments were really fun and interesting, but they were quite time consuming, and overall I did have a great time in the course. Anyways, so my exam is literally tomorrow and I still haven't started studying, so let's get to work. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 shots of me. Okay, so I lied, I didn't actually start at 10, it's like 11:30 right now, and now I'm gonna start by going through this 122-page document of notes. Let's get grinding. After a whopping 30 minutes of studying, I needed a break, so I got up and did some pull-ups. I think it's important to get up and do some exercise between study sessions, so if you're watching this, make sure to get a quick workout in today. So it's like 2:45 now, and I finally finished all my work for today, which wasn't even that much work, but it still took this long to finish. But it's like the end of the term, so I don't really have that much motivation left. I just want to get this last exam over with and then enjoy my 3-week break. Hopefully make some new videos for YouTube, and yeah, hope you enjoyed the video. As always, make sure to like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you all in the next one.